Tonight, we begin the first in a series of stories on the challenges many formerly incarcerated people face. William Brangham and producer Mike Fritz have this profile of Michael Plummer, who served more than 2 decades in prison. He was released 1.5 years ago, and he now works with at-risk youth to pass on the lessons he learned. It's part of our ongoing series, Searching for Justice.
For 42-year-old Michael Plummer, the reality of his freedom still hasn't set in.
You know, you say, okay, is this real? You know, am I driving this car or am I at this restaurant? And so I'm used to being home, but mentally, you know, the mind is always there.
There is the 23 years that Plummer spent in prison for a murder he committed when he was 16. He was released in 2020 thanks to a Washington, D.C. law that freed some longtime prisoners if their crimes were committed as juveniles. He's now been out for more than 1.5 years, and we've been following Plummer as he's rebuilt his life.
1, 2.
He reconnected with his daughter, Mayana, who was just 18 months old when he was arrested, and he became a grandfather.
And there we go.
And he married Ramel Thompson, who he had dated as a teenager. He now works 2 jobs, one working for Clean Decisions, a company that hires formerly incarcerated people.
You want to get people in your corner to champion you, so I champion you.
And another, working as what's known as a credible messenger, where he counsels young people who are in custody in Washington, D.C.
You always have a choice in every matter.
Plummer's partner in that job is 47-year-old Anthony Petty, whom he met in prison.
This time right here, you're basically in a confined area. Use this time to do something. And what you do, you know, you read, you learn.
When Petty was released last year, after being in prison for nearly 30 years for murder, Plummer helped him land this job and trained him how to do it.
He served a 30-year prison term. He reformed his life while in there. And even though he spent a lengthy time in prison, it didn't affect his, you know, mental capabilities of being stable. And so he's able to share with the youth a world of wisdom.
We went to jail when we were 16. So one of the most important things that I want to do with the young people is I don't want them to go through what me and Michael went through. That's the most important thing.
Right.
You know, and by me being around Michael and his workforce, the credible message workforce, you know, I learned a lot of things just being around him.
When I was young, you know, went down the path, I went down.
Research suggests this type of mentorship can have a big impact on young adults in the justice system. One study found that over a 2-year period, a similar credible messenger program in New York helped reduce felony reconviction rates by more than half.
I want to get out, go home, have a good job.
One young man in the Washington, D.C. program told me these mentors are trusted because of their own backgrounds.
They was incarcerated once before. They ain't let the 25 years, the 35 years of life impact them on what they got going on for the future. But they make us feel like that we are in their shoes and that we can do bigger things with our life. And we do have a future and we do have a family.
I know you as a mother, you always worry about what your son going through and stuff like that.
And Plummer and Petty often meet with parents of the young people they see, like Mother Ashley Angel Darton.
To him, it's like, oh, it's small, so why are they tripping? He doesn't take accountable for his actions.
Yeah. Darton says her son has been in and out of juvenile detention. They're trying to help her understand what he's been dealing with and how to help him.
Support them, but you know, you definitely gotta let them know, look, man, this ain't gonna be tolerated. You got some parents, like, they don't say nothing.
It's kind of hard to try to deal with a child that you don't understand, you know? So it's like, it was really good to work with somebody that understands where you're coming from, understand what you're going through, and they could just basically relate to everything you're doing.
While Plummer's long time in prison in some ways made him perfect for his job, it's not the same for his personal life.
I'm used to being an introvert. So a lot of times I still be in isolation mode, you know, even though I'm in society.
Plummer and his wife, Ramel Thompson, first met as teenagers. They both were single parents. They fell in love and they even talked about marriage. But then Plummer was arrested, convicted of murder, and given a 30-year to life sentence. So when you find out that he's going to go away for a long time, what was your reaction to that?
I was mad. I was pissed off.
Pissed off at?
Just the whole situation, him just leaving.
The two lost touch while Plummer was away, but when he got out, she says she had forgiven him.
I don't know if I asked her out or she asked me out.
You asked me out.
You sure?
I'm positive.
I think you asked me out.
No,
but,
you asked
but,
me.
But so
I'm gonna go with her on this.
Okay, we go with her.
Pretty soon, they fell back in love and got married.
There's gonna be a lot of stuff to move out.
Earlier this summer, they just celebrated their one-year anniversary and were busy packing up their D.C. apartment for a planned move into a new house that they were about to buy. Did this process feel natural to you from where you guys started and being apart and coming back together?
I know that when you meet somebody again, that it's a process. Forget about what happened 20-some years ago. You got to deal with it right here and now and see where it go from there.
But forgetting is not always the easiest thing in the world to do. How is that going for you?
1 year, it was kind of rough because this is something I'm new to also, being married. So I'm just one day at a time. I'm still learning him. He's still learning me. I mean, no marriage is perfect. We have our days.
But a few months later, the stresses on the relationship got worse. Plummer moved out and is now living in a separate apartment. They didn't buy the house. He and Thompson are now in marriage counseling.
I don't think nobody automatically has all the answers to a relationship. It's a trial and error, you know. Me going to prison, I didn't have a constant relationship with a woman. So with that said, you know, I'm not going to say it's me, I'm not going to say it's her. I'm going to say it's both of us, you know, just trying to, you know, dance around marriage and make it work between the both of us. I'm a human being, I'm a returning citizen, and I'm gonna have a normal life, the ups and downs of it. So I think with this going on right here, I think this is gonna bring us back together in a stronger bond.
He says this optimism and faith has been crucial to getting him to this point, and he hopes it will continue to pay off in the times ahead. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm William Brangham in Washington, D.C.